Hey everybody, Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a LEGO movie set. This is called Castle Cavalry and it comes with 424 pieces. This is a 2-in-1 set, so let's look at some of the smaller stuff first so then we can focus on the two major builds. The minifigs left to right are Sir Stackerbrick, a gallant guard, and then Sharon Shoehorn, an actress from the Where Are My Pants show. The two knights, or the two castle figures here, are from the modern castle series. They did not go back to the classic ones, so they are Lion Knights from sets that are still currently available in stores right now. And let me just take off this helmet so that you can see Sir Stackerbrick's face. And he's got the full complement of everything being printed top to bottom. And Sharon has a pretty plain top, but she's got the really glamorous light yellow hair on there. Let's take a look at these from the back. You see all of them do have prints back there, and I'll just take this off so you can see her alternate face, and we'll also take a look at that from the front. There's a better look at that, as well as a full view of the gallant guard's face, and that's it for the minifigs. The set includes one micromanager, and though it's one of the smaller micromanagers, it's one of my favorites from the series on the whole. It does not shoot anything. It's hollow from the back, so that's a little bit disappointing, but it has just two wheels in the middle that makes it kind of look like it wants to zip around and angle in turns like that. So that, to me, that just gives it a little bit of extra personality. It will stand up. You do have to balance it for a second. If you're a little bit off, it will fall over. You can actually help that to be more stable by changing how the claw is posed, but for just normal poses, just give it a little bit of patience and you'll get that to stand up. But I really like the claw also because it's got a good number of pieces and it has a lot of articulation. You can open the top and bottom up, you can open the entire large grip areas, you can also angle these kind of little finger bits in there. And the idea is that this is coming after the Sharon figure to try to gobble her up and take her away. So that's able to kind of reach in there and grab around her, something like that. So you see she's actually held off the ground, or you could lift it up a little bit more like that and you can see you can actually take a minifig away. It would be even more stable if you actually connected her hand, one of the hands to one of these, or had the arms up so you could get under her armpits to really hold on better. But still, this works out really well and I just like the character of that little guy. Castle Cavalry to the rescue. All right, these guys took their little encampment in front of a gate and rebuilt it and reimagined it into kind of a spaceship. And it's got these twin pontoon kind of sections up in the front, a little bit of inspiration from a number of sci-fi ships that have been designed in the past and some well-known themes. Here in the middle, you can see that you've got this double crossbow turret, which also has a main cannon in the center made of a little wine glass there, or goblet kind of thing, and it's got a sight on it. And the idea is that this guy is a major gunner there, so he's able to shoot in multiple directions, but that's not the only thing you're able to shoot with. You have catapults back here, twin catapults, which are able to fire off these pieces of ammunition. These are little just cylinder pieces, and you just load one of those in there. It almost wants to roll off because of how far back it's angled. I wish that they had stopped that a little bit farther up, but still, as long as you push this all the way forward, it will do a really nice arced shot towards the front, and you've got two of those, so you can load up both of them and then shoot. Ah, but there is even more that you can shoot with, because you see these? They're red, and you know what red means in the LEGO world. It means you can do something with those. These are remote activators for flick fire missiles in the front. And there those are. Those are the missiles right there. They're way, way up in the front. They've just got long activation rods, basically. And those just shoot off on either side of the lion head. I'll just capture it right here, but there you go. See, you just push from back here and these shoot out. That's a very nice action. It's smooth and it works really well. Sometimes those kind of remote setups don't work so well, but this one actually does. Last thing I want to focus on here is the kind of captain's bridge area, which has a very nicely done little design bit here with this rounded banister piece, the way that they connect it. It's actually on top of tiles, so you see there are tiles down here, because you can't connect this at an angle like that. It's actually angled 45 degrees off the norm right now, but they put tiles on the bottom, and it's actually connected with the use of those skeleton bones, or arms that are on the sides there. Those are hooked onto little clips on modified bricks on either side, and that's how they connected that. I think that's very nicely done, and allows you to use an interesting piece in an interesting way that's very effective. Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a 2014 LEGO castle set. Of course I'm kidding. This is just the alternate build, but it really does look like a castle set, doesn't it? I mean, just bring in the little minifigs here, and I really could just do this as a review of a set by itself, because it's perfect. In this form, it's exactly what it set out to be. And I think it looks really good for a little front of a castle. Like, you could set this, it could easily be sold just like this. So I'm very happy that they were able to bring in another theme into the movie and do a little conversion stuff with that. A lot of the things here are actually the same or very, very similar to what was in the primary build. Everything here, I mean, you can see once again that the way that banister is connected up here, and you know, you've still got the same turrets on the side. They just kind of took the center one, moved it over, you know, split up the parts just a little bit, but many things are exactly the same here, and you can almost just start to see the ship as soon as you turn it like this. It actually has more detail than some of the castle sets, with the studs on the side and a little bit of the lion head there. The gate is done very nicely. So we've got your torches on the sides. These are also little torches that you can use to kind of light up your entranceway, so you can set those wherever you want, just small little things. And the nice thing here is that the gate has a lock on it. You actually pull this out. So right now you can't open it, but you pull this out like so, and now you can actually open this up. So a nice little lock mechanism there. And the little dungeon section was included in the other build. You probably saw that, just a little skull there and a bone just kind of stuck. Either a dungeon section or a place where somebody just fell in during construction and they closed it all up and they forgot about him. Poor guy. And then you also get your catapults, because of course the catapults are included with the main build, and that's a big thing in the castle theme. So here's a setup here. It's a cart with two. Once again, you got your dual ones. Here's your ammo. Just load up one of these here and give it a shot. Didn't really go very far. Let me try hitting it a little harder. Yeah, really arcs the shot. So that shot, I hit it pretty hard, and it went about 10 inches in total. The problem is that this thing is angled back quite a lot, so put the little bucket under there just temporarily to kind of help give you a better angle for shooting with these. Once you do that, ammo in place. Yeah, went about twice as far that time. Well, that's a pretty cool set, and I'm glad that the castle theme got some love in the LEGO movie. Of the 2-in-1 sets that have been made available as of the time of this video, this is definitely my least favorite, mostly because when it's in this form here, it still looks like its original form with just very minor modifications. I think it is creative, I think it is thoughtful, but honestly I wish that they'd gone farther, taking the whole design farther away from the original form, you know, the pre-transformation form. The minifigs are nothing too special, but I do like them, especially the Sharon minifig. That's useful in many different scenarios. The special version of a micromanager included with this one, I do like a lot. I really like its grip. I like the way that it's on just two little wheels and balances and stuff. And overall, I do think that this is a good deal and a good set. It's just not my favorite. But what is your favorite? What are your favorites? Do you like this one? Do you not like it? Let your thoughts be known in the comment section on the video. Feedback is always appreciated, and other folks like to see more people's opinions as well. And while you're writing your comments, I'll be back building more stuff and bringing you more videos, so stay tuned, and I'll talk to you again soon.